Hello, Sophie here. I'm a 2D illustrator who wandered into Blender one day and I never left. So for today, the title is quite technical, and if you clicked on this video and you're not sure exactly what you're getting yourself into, basically I'll be sharing how I draw with grease pencil on surfaces without the headache. So let's just get into it. So let's start by opening up a new file and choosing 2D animation. So we have our grease pencil stroke object here, and we want to add a mesh to draw on top of. If we're in draw mode, we could switch into object mode up here, and then all we have to do is press Shift A, and for this example, let's just go into add mesh, and let's choose a UV sphere. So we won't make any changes to our sphere. Instead, let's select our grease pencil object and go into draw mode. Up here is where we can choose how our strokes will be placed. So origin and 3D cursor both result in drawing on flat planes, but if we select surface, then we can draw on our sphere and the strokes will follow our shape. Really cool. I use this like for most of what I do in 3D with grease pencil. Now notice when you draw that there's a gap between the strokes and the object. This is the offset. So we can modify that here with a larger number giving you a bigger gap. So the problem that I'm going to be trying to solve in this video is that this offset isn't consistent. If you draw while you're very zoomed in, the gap will be much smaller. And if you draw while you're very zoomed out, it'll be huge. I zoom in and out constantly when I draw. This doesn't work for me. You can set the offset to 0, but then it'll render really funny. Technically, this isn't a problem if you don't plan on including the mesh in your final render, but I draw on all sides of my object, and if I hide the meshes from my final render, I get this. I much prefer to keep my meshes and to give them a holdout material. Hey, really quick, probably would have been nice if I explained how to do this. So up here in the workspaces, I'm not sure if it's already included in the 2D animation. So in case it's not, if you go into sculpting and then you look for the shading workspace. So from there, we'll just click on our object that we want to change the material of. If it doesn't have any material, then we'll add one. And then basically just select this big box, hit delete, and then you can press Shift A, and then in shader, look for the holdout, and then just plug in the holdout to the surface. So basically what this does is this makes the object invisible, so it doesn't show up in the final render. But it still hides the strokes on the other side so that you're not seeing this mess. So maybe you're thinking, let's just make the offset 0 and then scale down our object. So fair. This will work in this example just because we're using a sphere and we haven't touched it at all, edited, sculpted it at all. But as soon as you have any object more complex than a sphere, scaling it down just flat out won't work. Here's kind of an example of what you'll get. Also, then, what if you need to go back and change your drawing at all? Scale it back up and hope for the best? Yeah, not a fan of that idea. So, here is my solution. So let's go back into object mode and select our mesh object. We're going to give it a solidify modifier. Before doing this, I recommend pressing Ctrl A and choose Apply All Transforms, because otherwise the modifier just acts pretty funky. So modifiers are found in this blue wrench icon, and the solidify modifier is here. Here I set the offset to 1, and typically I keep the thickness between 0.01 to 0.04. You can play around with that, see how it works with your piece. Then we can click on this blue camera icon over here and turn it off. This means that we'll see the modifier while we're working in Blender, while we're drawing on top of the object, but when we hit render, the object won't have this extra thickness. This means Yes. We can now draw on the object with the offset set to 0. When we render it, the strokes will all look perfect. They won't be affected by the mesh at all. And they'll be at, like, almost the exact same distance from the mesh, no matter how zoomed in or out you were when you drew them. Like, okay, if you zoom out a crazy amount, like, there's a small difference, but, oh my god, it's nothing like what it was before. And overall, they are just so much more consistent than if you were to use any value for the offset. So that's my trick. Please do comment down below if you have any questions or anything else you'd like to see me cover. I quite enjoy making these, and I'm actually started planning, like, a let's make something together start to finish style tutorial series. So definitely subscribe if that's something you'd be interested in. You could find me at Sophie Jantak on all social medias. And yeah, thank you for being here. I will see you very soon. Cheers. Wow, that was so fast. I hope the audio came out okay.